was very, very deeply motivated to, in 2008 to see Barack Obama. This wonderful, sort of a surprise, really. I couldn't believe our luck that we had gotten such a real person as to make it through the filter system of our politics. So it meant a lot to me, and I know that it would have meant a huge amount to my father. So, because I think of him often. And so, again, in 2012, Kim and I went on the road for Obama. We did, as Teresa said earlier, we did about 36 different events, and it was really restored my faith in the country to see, to meet these people who had committed themselves to this re-election campaign. It was the largest grassroots event that we've ever seen in this country, and the people involved were such just fundamentally such good people. I felt that it really meant a lot to me to be involved in it. They were smart too, the people who handled this campaign. They did it really well, and they were committed to this mission, and they really carried it out beautifully. I should say also that although I am a sort of relentless Democrat, I do believe that a dialogue between a reasonable dialogue between Republicans and Democrats is what keeps this country on course and in balance. I think that, you know, by ourselves, liberals would probably steer us towards a sort of paralyzed nanny state European style, and Republicans left on to their own would head towards oligarchy and inherited wealth and power. So I think that we really do need a strong Republican Party and a good dialogue between left and right. But paralysis seems to be the order of the day, and politics of fear. Anyway, I will rant on and on, and I promised Kim I wouldn't do too much of that. It was a delight being involved in the campaign, the Obama campaign. We had a wonderful time, and we went back to North Carolina. We played this song a lot. I'm not going to play the whole thing. It's too long. In my mind, I'm going to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? Ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? Oh, I'm going to Carolina in my mind. It's with holy hosts of others standing round me, and still I'm on the dark side of the moon, and it looks like it goes on like this forever. You must forgive me. If I am gone to Carolina in my mind, in my mind I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? Ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? I'll be gone to Carolina in my mind. Yes, I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. Oh, I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. Songwriter. You know, we have, there was something like 60%, 63% participation of eligible voters this last election. Off year elections, it's more like 40%. So average them out, we get 50% of our voters to the polls, and that's not good enough for what America is and for what it means. For some reason, we're dropping that ball. I think we need a day off for polling. We need to open the polls for a week. When we identify people, when we officially identify people, they should be registered. As soon as somebody has an official name and address, they should be able to get a note in the mail that tells them where to go to vote. This business of the question of gerrymandering for congressional districts is a profound conundrum. I don't know how we fix that, but we can at least get people to get to the polls in greater numbers. There are a lot of people who in the country who do want to go in the other direction, who want fewer people to vote. And these voter ID laws that are in the name of preventing voter fraud, I think it's a solution without a problem. The voter fraud in this country is pretty much equal to either side, and is so low that the amount of people who are discouraged from voting by these new ID laws, it's just a bad idea in my opinion. Also, if you're concerned about voter fraud, a paper trail for Diebold voting machines, which one-third of our country votes on, some kind of accounting possibility for Diebold machines so that we can check every 100th machine against its actual paper trail is a much better and a much more effective way to insure against voter fraud. You can go on Google, you can find 20 different hacking experiments that people have performed on these machines, and Diebold wears its political heart on its sleeve. They're very political there. You know, they contribute hugely to political campaigns. So a paper trail for Diebold machines would be an excellent idea to make sure that was not being hacked, because it's been repeatedly proven that it is embarrassingly easy to hack the returns of Diebold machines. So that needs to happen. Anyway, that's the election reform part of my speech, and I'm going to end with another song that Kim and I sang when we were out on the trail. Kim actually thought, until she was about 12 years old, she thought that the picture of FDR on her grandmother's mantelpiece was her grandfather. She thought they did look a lot alike, but she. Her grandmother was such a fervent New Dealer that she also inoculated Kim in no small way into liberal politics. It's true.
From sea to shining sea.